What is going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty. The Wolfpack are on the road for another conference matchup as they'll face the Chippewas of Central Michigan. And despite Illinois Tech having some defensive struggles to start the year, they have managed to get through the first half of the season with a 5-1 record, which has them one away from being bowl eligible in their first season of play on the FBS level. Both divisions in the MAC conference have two front-runner teams, with Illinois Tech and Bowling Green being the front-runners in the East. They'll play next week, but here goes the opening kickoff in Lucas Baker from the goal line, trying to make something happen early for Illinois Tech in the return game, and no one blocked that guy. Baker hit hard after a 16-yard return, and out comes Anthony Bishop and the Wolfpack offense getting started on the ground. Once again, counter left. Bishop breaks away from one and is brought down after an 8-yard run. Illinois Tech from the pistol on second down, going back to Bishop, wide open lane up the middle of the defense, and Bishop brought down across the 35-yard line, 13-yard run. Good start for the ground game this week, already 21 yards on two carries. McKnight in motion on first and 10. It's going to be a sweep to the left side, trying to get around the edge, and McKnight put down behind the line. That'll lose two. Trying to get a little more creative with the play calling, did not work there. Second and 12, going to the option, and the block's not set up on the outside, and Sean Kelly loses one. All of a sudden, third and long for Illinois Tech. Kelly from the shotgun as the Wolfpack go five wide. Kelly, time to throw against the four-man rush. Looks outside for Vandenberg. First down, Wolfpack. That's good for 15 yards. Nice catch by Vandenberg. Always comes through on third down. Illinois Tech from midfield goes to a screen. That's Bishop out the backfield. Blocks in front, and Bishop able to pick up a first down, but can't get past that last line of defenders. The blocking just broke down there. That's good for 16 yards. Going to Caden Garrick to the outside. First carry of the ball game. That's good for 8. Illinois Tech moving the ball pretty well this first drive. Third and 2, going to the option again. Kelly trying to get the first down and will just barely find it. That's good for 5 yards. Good job blocking by the old line. Man in motion on second down is Angel Parker. Illinois Tech goes to the ground, and Bishop nowhere to go. Brought down after a 1-yard carry. It's third and 5. Can the Wolfpack keep this drive going? Shotgun option left side for Kelly, and Kelly able to find a first down. That's a pretty favorable spot right there. It's first and 10. Illinois Tech goes play action. Kelly looking for someone open downfield. No one there. Kelly trying to scramble, lose the football, scooped up by Central Michigan, and the drive has come to an end. Illinois Tech put together a beautiful 5-minute drive, wasting a lot of time in the first quarter just for it to end in no points in the red zone. Kelly just out of steam, couldn't hold on to the football there. And Central Michigan, they'll take over inside their own 15-yard line. Cooper Rush from the shotgun throws to the outside for Anthony Rice. That's a 3-yard gain for the Chippewas to get going. They'll hurry back to the line, second and 7. Cooper Rush from the shotgun again, throws for Chapman. That's good enough for a first down as Central Michigan will move the chains. Let's see if they can get the ball downfield as easily as Illinois Tech did. First and 10, Rush throwing under pressure, looks outside for Rice, who gets upfield, able to break away from one defender. Rice still going down the sideline in Illinois Tech territory and finally brought down inside the 25-yard line. 53-yard catch and run for Anthony Rice. Illinois Tech needs to do a better job wrapping up receivers. First and 10 to the outside. There goes Rice again. 3 receptions already. That's good for 6 yards. Central Michigan is yet to run the ball. Third and inches. They will go to the air once again. Rush under pressure. Throws to the flat for Rice. Rice gets away from Horn. He's in the end zone. And Illinois Tech in trouble already defensively. Cooper Rush and the Chippewas offense just did whatever they wanted this drive. It took the Wolfpack offense 5 minutes to get down the field. Their first drive, Central Michigan went downfield and scored in almost a minute. That is unbelievable. Back to the ground game with Bishop, and this time going to the outside, second and 8, and Bishop able to cross the first down marker. That's good for 9 yards. From the shotgun, going back to the ground game, Bishop tripped up and brought down across the 35-yard line, and Bishop rolls over after his 6th carry of the ball game, and in comes Caden Garrick. 3rd and 7. Are we going to see the starter switch rolls again? Kelly to the air, throws and almost picked off, looking for Jason Howard. That is Josh Cox, and Illinois Tech will get the ball back to the Chippewas. They'll start from the 45-yard line, and this defense needs to make some plays, get some pressure on the quarterback as Rush throws underneath for a 3-yard gain. That'll take us to the second quarter. 2nd and 7, Rush from the shotgun again, all day to throw as Illinois Tech's getting no pressure on the QB. Rush throwing down the right sideline. He's got Kroll inside the 15, inside the 5, touchdown Central Michigan. Jesse Kroll, 52-yard catch and run. Central Michigan scoring quicker than they did their first drive. This defense needs to step up. Three plays, 64 yards, under a minute again. And Illinois Tech officially trails 14-0. They are not playing like a 5-1 team. This offense needs to wake up, and so obviously does the defense. First and 10, Illinois Tech starts from the 35, and is Kelly to the air, man, throwing up field for T.C. Shelton across midfield. That's good for 18 yards. Good play by the Wolfpack. Second down, they'll go to a screen underneath against zone coverage. That is Lucas Baker able to find a first down, shows off the speed, and gets Illinois Tech down to the 35-yard line. We've seen him in the return game. Nice to see him get some catches here and there. First and 10, and going outside to Jason Howard. Back-to-back first downs for Illinois Tech. Kelly really moving this offense down the field, putting some heat on these throws as they go to a screen on first and 10, and Bishop able to find 5 yards there in the red zone once again. Hopefully this time not turning the ball over. Second and 5, clean pocket for Kelly, throwing towards Howard, who had a step on his man at least 3. That should have been a touchdown. It is now 3rd and 5. Kelly to the air, runs out of time, but finds T.C. Shelton past the marker at the 10-yard line. It's 1st and goal for the Wolfpack. Can they punch this ball in the end zone? Going to the ground game. This is Bishop inside the 5-yard line. Trip from behind, 7-yard gain. It's 3rd and goal from the 2. Goal line packages for both teams on the field. Illinois Tech goes to the outside as Central Michigan plug the middle, but no one at the edge. Anthony Bishop in for another touchdown. That'll cut this lead to a 1-score deficit. 2:44 in the second quarter, and here goes Central Michigan. This is their first run of the ball game, and Devon Spaulding picks up 12 yards on a first down. So far, Illinois Tech's been getting beat through the air. Now they got to worry about a ground game as Central Michigan goes option, and Ashley Curtis, nice play behind the line. That'll bring up 3rd and 13. Now would be a nice time for this defense to get these guys off the field. Cooper Rush from the shotgun throws down the seam, and he's going to be nearly picked off by Gabe Hunter. That'll bring up 4th down. 4:04 left in the first half. Plenty of time with 3 timeouts to get down the field and tie this ball game up as Bishop runs hard again to the outside. That's good for 5 yards. Good start for him. 5-wide set on 3rd and 5. Kelly to the air, throws underneath for Howard, who makes the catch and cuts back upfield. 9-yard gain, 1st down, Wolfpack. 2:22 left, Illinois Tech still with 3 timeouts as Kelly looks downfield for McKnight, who can't hold on. Tight throw into a tight window, and McKnight couldn't make the grab. Now it's 3rd down and 10. Illinois Tech goes play action. Not sure who would fall for that on 3rd and 10, but somehow Kelly still hooks up with Brandon Archer for a 10-yard gain and a 1st down, first catch of the game for him. Minute 49 left in the first half as Kelly throws for Shelton, and he wasn't looking for the football, not on the same page there, as that'll bring up 2nd and 10, staying 5-wide. Kelly throwing right side this time as McKnight got good separation. 13-yard gain, Illinois Tech at the 25-yard line, but now facing 3rd down and 11. Kelly from the shotgun, 4-man rush, gets through, and down goes Kelly. And that might have just taken these guys out of field goal range. It is now 4th and 21, 18 seconds left, and the offense staying on the field, thinking they can get one playoff here for a 1st down, and that will not happen. Tony Aness able to knock that one away, and Central Michigan takes over with 12 seconds left. All this defense needs to do is keep these guys out the end zone. Cooper Rush all day to throw, though. Steps up and fires left side for Mark Chapman, who makes the catch inside the 5. Are you kidding me? Unbelievable. This defense couldn't stop a cold. Cooper Rush throws his 3rd touchdown of the ball game. This is not happening. Isaiah Taylor in position, couldn't make the play, couldn't make the tackle. Deion Reeves couldn't make the tackle. And this defense is in trouble. Illinois Tech trails 21-7. Game not over yet, but still a lot of work to do on both sides of the football. It's Central Michigan football to begin quarter number 3. And this defense from Illinois Tech needs to step up and get these guys off the field immediately. But Devon Spaulding has other plans, breaking free across midfield. And he finds 30 yards on his 3rd carry of the ball game. They haven't really used him a lot this game, but he's been pretty big. Breaks away from Hunter on his next carry and is brought down at the line of scrimmage by a gang of Wolfpack defenders. That'll bring up 3rd and 10 later in the drive, and Cooper Rush from the shotgun looking to get this ball past the marker. That's Anthony Rice breaking free again inside the 15, and luckily tackled by Reeves inside the 10-yard line at about the 6-7-yard line. It's 1st and goal, and they'll go back to the ground game. Devon Spaulding breaks free, and he gets through Reeves for a touchdown. This defense just cannot stop anybody right now, as they let Central Michigan score in under a minute. Illinois Tech looking to respond to the air. That is Travis Vandenberg again breaking free, 1st down. That's good for 18 yards. Ball at the 42-yard line. Kelly from the pistol. They got to get down the field and in a hurry. Kelly throwing outside to T.C. Shelton. Almost gets past the defender. A little bit of misdirection there. Good for a first down up to the 40-yard line. First and 10. Kelly to the air. Throwing for Vandenberg again. This time good for 12. A first down machine. Travis Vandenberg, three receptions and 45 yards. Kelly on the option up the middle. Not going to slide. He's trying to pick up every yard he can. Picks up 15 yards as he spun down. Caden Garrett checks in on second down up the middle, runs through a defender and is spun down inside the 5-yard line. Illinois Tech looking to respond. It's first and goal. Goal line package for the Wolfpack on the field. Give to Caden Garrett. The Bruiser powers his way in for a touchdown. This is down to a 2-score deficit again. The offense trying to get things going in the second half. Now it's up to the defense. But before that, a 2-point conversion is Bishop to the right side in for the 2-point conversion. That is good. It's now a 13-point ball game. Here goes the defense. They bring heat and Spalding brought down the backfield. It's about time somebody made a play. Good tackle by Mac Orton. Second and 13, rush to the air. Throw is caught complete for a short gain. Good for 6 to Jonathan Carson. Now it's 3rd and 8 for Central Michigan. Rush to the air again, throws underneath for Carson. First down, Chippewas. He crosses the 45. That's good for 10 yards. Defense almost had him right there. Rush from the shotgun. He'll throw once again. They are not running the ball that much this game. And Chapman with the reception, brought down by Gabe Hunter. And now Chapman's injured. That's one less playmaker for Illinois Tech to have to worry about on defense. But 3rd down and 3, can they get the Chippewas off the field? Rush will throw on 3rd down underneath for Conklin. Horn can't make the tackle. Conklin picks up a 1st down. He crosses the 40, and he's in Illinois Tech territory. This has just been the season so far. You got to make tackles on first attempt. 3rd and 10, going to a screen, and this will be busted up in the backfield. That is Jamie Horn as Spalding falls forward for a 1-yard gain. And a pretty interesting play call here from Central Michigan. They won't punt. They'll try the long field goal. And that gives Illinois Tech better field position as they'll take over from near the 40-yard line. Sean Kelly to the air on 2nd down. Hooks up with Jason Howard near the marker. That's good for 9 yards to bring up 3rd and 1. Caden Garrett checks in. Give to him. He's going to get near the marker. Can't find it. But obviously, Illinois Tech stays on the field. 4th and 1. Goal line package again. That's Bennett Hayden, the fullback, the senior up the middle. Useful in these kind of situations. 6-yard gain. Illinois Tech keeps their drive going. 1st and 10. Kelly throwing, and how did T.C. Shelton make that catch? That's good for 12 yards. Great coverage, but the defender not looking for the football. Going back to the ground game, this is Caden Garrick around the edge. If Bishop was in the game, that could have been a touchdown. Caden Garrick just not enough speed to get around the edge right there. Bishop in on 2nd down, but it's Kelly running right side on the option, able to pick up a 1st down and sliding inside the 15 down to the 12. It's 1st and 10. Now 2nd and 5 with a little bit of time left in the 3rd quarter. Kelly on the QB draw up the middle, 4-yard gain. 3rd and 1. Can the Wolfpack punch it in to begin the 4th quarter? Goal line set. Bishop to the outside. Good blocking on the edge. He's in again. Touchdown, Illinois Tech. Gets down to a 1-score ball game. They've carved their way back in. Down 3 touchdowns, but the defense still needs to make some plays. Central Michigan getting started from the 30-yard line, up by 6 points, and is rushed to the air once again. Rushed by Hunter. Gets away from him, but can't get away from the second guy. That is Cam Wolf with the first sack on the ball game. Defense finally gets through. 2nd and 18. Rush to the air once again. Illinois Tech still bringing pressure. Quick throw to Rice on the outside. Good for 6 yards. 3rd and 12. And the defense right now with a good chance to get these guys off the field. Rush. Time to throw. Looks underneath for Jesse Kroll. Good catch, but can't get past the defense. 4 yards shy of the marker. And Illinois Tech forces their 1st 3-and-out of the ball game. Illinois Tech looking for a blocked punt here. Can't get it as Lucas Baker deep on the return. He'll bring this one from the 25-yard line and able to make one guy miss and gets past the 40-yard line, spun down. That's a 15-yard gain. And here comes Sean Kelly in the offense. They got a chance to make a statement here and say that, hey, we might be down sometimes, but we're never really completely out of the ball game, as Bishop carries right side for a 9-yard gain. Might be looking at him a little more this drive as they try to burn down some clock in this 4th quarter. 2nd and 1. Kelly down the seam. He's got Archer. Forget trying to burn clock. These guys are trying to score immediately. That's a 26-yard gain. From the pistol for a wide set. Kelly with time to throw against a 3-man rush. Looks downfield for Howard. If he had thrown that maybe a second earlier, Ness wouldn't have been there to knock it away. But it's 2nd and 10. Illinois Tech still throwing. Kelly time to throw. He's got Baker inside the 10-yard line, and the ball comes out. It gets stripped out, and that's going to be a forced fumble and a recovery for Central Michigan. Illinois Tech yards away from tying this ball game up and taking the lead, but Central Michigan just took all the momentum away. What a play from a nest. Saved the touchdown the previous play by knocking it away. Saved a big time first down by forcing the fumble. This is unbelievable. I've never seen anything like this. Never in my life. That is the worst time for the CPU to try to strip the ball, and it actually works. And unfortunately for Illinois Tech, that is going to get the ball back to Central Michigan, as they're going to try to get back down the field with 5:46 remaining. And Reeves nearly gets the ball right back to the offense. You got to catch the ball, two hands on it. Somebody make the guy do some push-ups. Second and 10, rush to the air. Illinois Tech still bringing heat. That's a throw in, a completion to Carson. Good for 7. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 3 for Central Michigan. They'll go to the option. Rush carrying towards the left side of the field. Able to slip one tackle and brought down after a 13-yard gain. And Illinois Tech has to get these guys off the field with a new set of downs. 1st and 10, rush still throwing underneath for Kroll. And he is hit hard by Gabe Hunter. That's a 6-yard gain. But now it's 3rd down and 4. They'll go to the option. Rush running right side and runs through Hunter. Unbelievable. These quarterbacks run like fullbacks. 1st down, Central Michigan. Got to bring these guys down behind the line of scrimmage. They go to the option. That's a pretty poor play on the ball. Xavier Hunter was in position trying to make a play on a rush. That didn't happen. 1st and 10 from the 30-yard line. Rush back to the air. Throws towards Rice. Rice able to make the catch. Breaks away from one. And he's in the end zone again. Touchdown, Central Michigan. It's a 2-score ball game again. 4:10 left, and Illinois Tech still down by 12 points as Central Michigan missed the extra point. And it's Kelly back to the air, throwing downfield, and that is going to be thrown into double coverage for Howard. I guess Kelly getting a little impatient here, as it's now 2nd down and 10. Kelly back to the air, rolling out to his left, trying to find someone open downfield, and able to get away. He'll just tuck in and run for a 1st down and out of bounds at the 40-yard line. That's good for 14. Kelly back to the air, 5-wide set, rolling out to his right, and will wind up throw T.C. Shelton with the catch. That's a short gain. That's good for 6 yards. 5-wide set again. Kelly time to throw against a 3-man rush, looking for Vandenberg and Tony Inez. The defensive playmaker so far for Central Michigan has a pick. That's a 3rd turnover for Illinois Tech on the ball game. That throw just came out a little too late. 1st and 10. Spaulding on the ground, carries upfield, tripped up after a short gain. That's good for 1. As Illinois Tech is trying to keep these guys from getting back down the field and adding even more points. Good tackle in the open field by Gabe Hunter, as that'll bring up 3rd down and 4. Illinois Tech trying to keep these guys from converting. Quick throw to Rice in the flat, and Rice able to find a 1st down. That's good for 10 yards. Central Michigan has us inside of 2 minutes with 3rd and 4 again. Minute 35 left in the ballgame, and Illinois Tech out of timeout. Screen set up to the left side. That is Spaulding getting away from Reeves. He gets away from Hunter. Are you kidding me? He's in the end zone, and Cooper Rush has thrown his 5th touchdown of the ballgame. This defense has looked atrocious all game, and that play right there, that just sums it all up. Guys aren't where they need to be, and then the guys that have chances to make tackles can't make them. And this is something that needs to get looked at and fixed immediately, because the competition this year is much harder than Central Michigan. 41-22, Illinois Tech back on the field. They start 5-wide, trying to at least get something going here to end the ball game. It would be nice to get some points, but Sean Kelly sacked. He'll lose 2 yards. Back to the line, 2nd and 12. Kelly to the air again. Throws outside, and a quick throw to Howard. Luckily not picked off there again. That's 12 yards and a 1st down for Jason Howard. 2nd and 10, Kelly back to the air, and he will look downfield. This is Howard with a catch, somehow able to make the grab there again. 38-yard gain, and Illinois Tech inside the 30-yard line. 2nd and 2, Kelly back to the air. He will throw towards T.C. Shelton, who's able to cross the goal line, and Illinois Tech, where was this drive earlier on? That's not going to win them the ball game, but it does make things a little more respectable. 28-41, onside kick from Gonzalez. The kick is going to skip once, and Central Michigan will recover, and they'll just come out here and look to kneel the football with 34 seconds left, and Illinois Tech can't do anything about it as Central Michigan will upset the Wolfpack, and Illinois Tech will not get to their bowl game quite yet. They're 5-2 as Cooper Rush, player of the game. 24-31, 300 plus yards, 5 touchdowns. This was not a great game for Illinois Tech, despite Kelly throwing for 305 yards, but the ground game really wasn't a factor this week, as it has been really earlier in the year. But the main issue this game, obviously, was the defense. This was not a great game. So many missed tackles. I wish they tracked missed tackles because there were just too many this game. We know there's a tackling issue on this team. We know the talent's not fair at the defensive end. But this was atrocious. The tackling in the red zone, the tackling downfield, the awareness from the secondary to make plays on jump balls. Like that touchdown at the end of the first half that went to Chapman. Taylor was in position, couldn't make a play. And then when these guys are in position to make plays, like I said earlier, we don't come away with the football. There is at least two or three chances for picks. But Illinois Tech advancing in the Week 10. And we are getting some help on defense. Jack Cobbs, the free safety, and subscriber, the first subscriber recruit, Jonathan West. Welcome to Illinois Tech as the Wolfpack taking on Bowling Green in Week 10. And this will be a battle for the lead in the MAC East. Bowling Green lost this week, so did Illinois Tech, obviously. And Northern Illinois on the west side, they just keep on winning. They're 7-1. So taking a look at the remaining five games on the schedule, Bowling Green, NIU, Notre Dame, Akron, and Ohio. Here's a look at the Heisman top five. Leonard Fournette still leading, Taj Griffin, Deshaun Watson, Samaje Perine, and then Tyler Rouse of Boston College. They just keep on winning. And here's an updated look at the top 25. LSU, the number one team, Michigan 2, Ohio State 3, and Texas A&M at number 4. And to round out the top 25, there is Western Kentucky. So we'll take a look at the two guys ready for visits this week. There is Maurice Dowdell and Adam Matthews, who I'm not super excited about. I talked about this during the recruit video earlier in the year, but he's got good speed, but he just takes so long to get there, and he doesn't really have great hands. But he will come in week 13 for the game against Akron. I don't really feel like he's a priority for us right now. But then Maurice Dowdell, I talked about him also. He's not fast. But he's got great coverage ability. His block shedding is kind of an issue, and his tackling's not really that great, but he's got pretty good play wrecking, pretty good pursuit, and good hit power. So I consider moving him to safety, but unfortunately he does have a conflict in week 11 with David Davis, so he will also come in week 13 for the game against the Akron Zips. And then taking a look at some of the other big-name recruits, five-star receiver Eric Torrijos, a subscriber. We're pretty much the only team on his board right now. We're just waiting for him to commit. And then we're still kind of in this battle for Quentin McKenzie. We're still slowly pulling ahead of Utah and Miami, Ohio, but he does visit them in week 13 and 14. So we'll see what happens with him. Henry Ellison, we are starting to kind of lose ground. Is somehow Kentucky and Missouri are pulling comebacks. They're starting to gain some points there, which is a little concerning. And then looking at our other tight end, Fred Edwards, we've lost our lead with him. I guess that loss to Central Michigan kind of impacting our standing with him, as North Carolina State has moved ahead of us for that tight end. So we'll take a look at the upcoming game against Bowling Green. They've got a couple prospects coming in, and obviously we are looking for win number 6, but this will be a battle between high-powered offenses and not the greatest defenses in the MAC Conference. Illinois Tech looking for a rebound as we have fallen back to 5-2 and hopefully not going on a 2-game skid to drop us back to 5-3. That, guys, will do it for the video. Hope you enjoyed. The Illinois Tech Dynasty obviously still going strong, but a little bit of a break as I had to transition over to a new PC that I just finished building. It works, but I'm not in love with the audio drivers. I feel like the mic quality has gone down a little bit with this new computer. I'm still trying to get that figured out. So if you guys notice like a difference between mic quality, or maybe it's always been like this and I never heard this with the audio drivers on my other computer, but I listen to my videos on my phone sometimes to make sure that audio quality is fine. So I'll see how this one uploads. But I'm not really in love with this when I'm listening to it live. Also, there's some reverb, because I actually ended up kind of changing my setup. So my foam wall covers that kind of help with cutting down on reverb and echo, those are kind of not up right now. I need to get those back up. So that might be causing some feedback in the video. But hopefully the next video I upload, I'll have this audio issue figured out. I'll have the foam back up so you guys won't be hearing any echo, because I can kind of hear it out of my non-headphone covered ear. But that, guys, will do it for the video. Hope you enjoyed. If you're new to the channel and you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe for more, and I will see you guys next time. Have a nice day. Keep it cool. See you later.